The theater getting ready for the final flight in the original dance. Keep in mind, tomorrow night we have the free dance competition for you. As well, we have ice hockey tomorrow on day 10 of the Winter Olympics. You should have heard the buzz a few moments ago when the legends stepped on the ice, Torval and Dean. And I know everyone's here for a competition tonight, Brian and Debbie, but they all want to see Torval and Dean.
Including Brian and I, they have been miraculous here during practice. Here they are stepping off the ice. Jane Torval and Christopher Dean, the 1984 Olympic champions, the only reinstated pros back in this event. They've been somewhat discouraged by their third place finish after the compulsory dances, but they're back, and I personally feel that their original dance is the best.
It is their strongest, and they won this portion of the competition at the European Championships.
Krylova and Fedorov from Russia are next to skate. Goolsby and Schomburger from Germany. Mratsova and Simicek from the Czech Republic. Torval and Dean from Great Britain. And the finale by the Finnish team of Rakamo and Koko. Next, Angelika Krylova and Vladimir Fedorov. They are from Moscow and one of the several teams we mentioned earlier, coached by Natalia Linichuk.
They shocked the ice dancing world when last year at the World Championships, for the first time at a championship of that level, they got a bronze medal.
Their first world appearance.
First time in 19 years since that had happened.
And it was Natalia Linichuk who did it, with her partner Gennady Karponosov. Tiny slip. Back into the dance very quickly.
It's probably the worst place on the ice to make a mistake because it was right in front of the judges.
A few tiny problems for Angelika Krylova and Vladimir Fedorov. But the fact the little stumble was right in front of the judges, they might not have even seen it. I can understand why this team was third at Worlds last year. They have a looseness, the comfort quotient, you know?
Certain charisma as well.
Yeah, they just... There was no stiffness involved in the dance. I always feel when I see that kind of fluidity, the body language makes you feel comfortable to watch them.
Well, the body language tonight certainly was rumba, that's for sure.
Look at the feet. Angelika has boot covers on. There was the little trip. Seemed that she just got stuck and kicked by Vladimir's foot as he pushed. I think boot covers make skaters' feet look huge. Like it. Composition marks, very good.
The marks for composition, 5-4, 5-4, 5-3,
They are sixth after the first two compulsory dances. The look of the bronze medal seems very far away for this team. Torval and Dean ahead of them, Rakamo and Coco ahead of them.
10.4, 10.4, 10.5, 10.6, 10.6, or 10.6.
And at this point, their original dance marks move them into fourth place. Four skaters to follow. Victor Kratz and Yushi Kessler looking on. Victor's done his work for tonight.